sower, and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord. Bless the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." The Gospel of the Lord. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. In our liturgy this morning, we celebrate the feast of St. Lawrence. St. Lawrence was a deacon of the Church of Rome in the 3rd century during the Roman persecutions of the Emperor Valerian. And one day, one of the prefects of the Emperor called in Lawrence, and he told Lawrence to bring to him the treasures of the Church of Rome. Well, Lawrence went out, and he got all the poor and the hungry people that the Church was taking care of in the city of Rome. And he brought all of these poor and hungry people to the prefect. And he said to him, here are all the treasures of the city of Rome. Needless to say, the prefect wasn't happy. Needless to say, Lawrence would become a martyr in the faith. Lawrence was willing to become that grain of wheat. Unless it dies, it cannot bear. Our Lord asked you and me, in a sense, to imitate Lawrence, not to go through a He wants us to learn to put aside our will and do His will. You know, when everything is going fine and God's doing exactly what we would like Him to do, it's easy to do His will. But on the opposite side of the coin, when we have to face a lot of difficulties and sorrows and hardships, it's not as easy to say, "Thy will be done." But yet, unless we become a grain of wheat, we won't produce much fruit. So the Lord wants us day by day to learn to put aside our will and to do His will. We will not accomplish this in a day, a month, or a year, but it takes, I think, a whole lifetime. And so each day we must ask for the grace not to do our will, but to do His will. And if we do that, we will become that grain of wheat. And in dying, we will produce a yield of 30, of 60, or of 100-fold. God bless you.
Receive with favor, O Lord, the offerings we joyfully make on the feast day of St. Martin's, and grant that they become a help to our salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim